Welcome to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show. I'm Keith, along with Morgan.
Hello, everybody.
We're glad to have you with us this Saturday, and we hope you enjoy the subject of our show today. It is how to control and reduce costs in remodeling. That's something that we all want to do, isn't it? If we're going to do remodeling or change our home, we'd like to be able to control that cost. And we're going to take your calls live also, 737-1200. Or 1-800-383-WOAI. Again, that local number is 737-1200. If you'd like to make a call, I'll take it, Morgan, and I will take your questions and answer them live on the air. Mm-hmm. So just talk to Captain Kirk back there and he'll take care of you. He takes care of us every Saturday, and we're glad. So speaking on this subject of how to control and reduce costs in remodeling, I think there's a way that most people try to do it right off the bat. What do you think? Do you have any ideas on that, Morgan?
I don't know what you're thinking, so you say what you're thinking.
Okay, well, I'm thinking about choose a different contractor.
Oh.
They think, well, I'll get one that charges less.
Yeah.
That is probably the number one way that people try to control their costs.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't think that's the right way, because that is not usually accurate at all. You're not really controlling your costs. You're just controlling how much you think you're going to pay at the beginning, and then it changes.
Yeah.
So you've heard that in other shows we've talked about, that, you know, people aren't really charging different mm-hmm. for the same thing. They're charging different for something different. And
exactly.
So that's the number one thing that you should remember in this show, is reducing cost is not by one contractor over another.
No.
You're going to find that if it's the exact same thing, you're going to spend about the same with any contractor. The question is, you know, what do you eventually settle on that you want and that is most important to you?
Mm-hmm.
So it's no different than buying a car. We bought one yesterday in the family, and you're not going to get a huge difference between pricing.
From dealerships.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
And I would say the difference you're going to see from dealerships is really close to the difference you're going to see in contractors mm-hmm. if you were comparing apples to apples.
Mm-hmm.
And it's difficult to do it in cars sometimes, because there's certain things on this model that aren't on the others. And maybe the ad for this car has nothing on it. And you don't know what it would cost if it had the things you want on it. And this car you're looking at has more on it, which you like, but you're not sure if you want to, you know, how much more you're paying. But that is, you know, somewhat difficult in cars.
Mm-hmm.
And for a lot of people, it's just very, very hard. But it's way more difficult to do in remodeling, because it's a custom, one-off. You're not buying something that's already pre-made. And so to get and to understand the differences between bids is extremely difficult, because they're not all bidding the same thing. But once you've gotten it down to, okay, I know what contractor I'm going to use, there's still a lot of things that can be done between you and your contractor to control cost. And I think the first thing that comes to my mind is making sure that it's an intelligent design.
Yeah.
And that means, you know, budget friendly as much as possible to get what you want. And I don't think you can do an intelligent design until you know everything that's in this house that relates to that project.
Mm-hmm.
That might be the meter panel, the main breaker panel out there needs to be understood. If something has to change there, you need to know where it's at and what are its capacities. Your plumbing, your septic, your drains, the size of your drains, all of this needs to be known. And where are they?
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, the example I've used many times is, if you have a power source for an oven, let's say it's a 220, and it's got a nice heavy wire going back to the panel, if you know which direction the panel is, then you know if it will actually have that wire and that circuit is long enough in the new configuration.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't pay attention to that, you're going to just assume that it won't work. But if you design it to where it could still be used, it doesn't have to be in the same location in many cases, but it has to be going in the right direction. Now, in some cases, you can do a junction box or something to save that circuit anyway, but you need to know these things. And so the first thing we say is, you know, we have to know what's here. And by the way, if you pay an architect to just draw your plans and you want to give that to contractors, because that's the way you're going to do your project, that does not tell them what is there. That architect is drawing what you want it to look like in the future, but doesn't show all these details. And if you're going to do that, you're going to pay another $1,500 just to get that information.
Yeah.
So be careful about hiring an architect that only does part of the job and not all of it. And then there's another thing that they often don't do, and that's the interior design finish out, layouts of tile, backsplashes, showers, glass details, and all that's not part of it with an architect. So be careful. At KM Builders, we give you a price to cover it all, including the as-builts, what's there now, or existing conditions, as we call it. And then the finished part of it is also included, as well as 3D renderings,
mm-hmm.
which many architects will not do for you for that price they're giving you also. And so you'll end up spending more, but you really need all these components to be able to control your cost. And especially that part we said earlier, the initial assessment, the discovery process that is used to know everything that's there. And then you start with intelligent designs that know that, hey, this is built this way, that's built that way, there's a structural header here, this is a structural wall, this is not a structural wall, here's where the electrical is heavy, here's where the manifold for the piping comes up. We know that this is probably where it's at, but that takes some investigation and some thinking about it also to figure out where would it likely be. And then sometimes a little more discovery is needed. Sometimes bringing up trades professionals to say, what are we looking at here? Which way is this going to work? Is this going to be sufficient? Air conditioning is another thing. You can go ahead and every contractor can just tell you, yeah, you need to change your air conditioner. But do you really? Is that because they don't know anything about air conditioners, or they didn't look at your specifications? Are they telling you it's old, so you need to replace it? Well, I have one that's 26 years old, and it's working fine. You know, it didn't for a little while, but we got that fixed. But, I mean, it's 26 years old, and it was 14 SEER. They're still selling 14 SEERs today. So, I mean, you can spend a lot of money unnecessarily if you don't get good advice. And I never advise someone to pull out their AC unless it's just not going to be sufficient size. But many times there's other solutions, you know, mini splits.
Mm-hmm.
And so know what's there first and then create an intelligent design. The intelligent design will not only look great, but it will flow with the building. It will reduce cost. One of my favorite intelligent designs that I came up with years ago, and I don't come up with most of the designs, but on this one, is whenever you're building out and the roof is way up there and you don't want to have to go all the way to meet the roof, or there's windows and you know the roof is going to intersect the windows, right?
Mm-hmm.
If you build out, the roof gets pulled out further, so then it starts shooting into the windows. So we've actually pulled out the building, and from the edge, what you see is the same roof line, but then it tapers off to a really shallow pitch that makes it line up under the windows. And you can't see that part of the roof, but it's a low slope roof material, either a rubberoid or a EPDM type of product. And it works and saves sometimes $10,000, $15,000 in roof designs. So those are things that can be done if you think outside the box. And as a design team, that's what we're really, really trying to do in every project. And sometimes it'll just be one person that will come up with a, you know what, we can do this instead. And wow, does that save a lot of money? And that's what we all want to do. We know that if we can get the price down, you're much more likely to buy it. And you can use that somewhere else in the project, or it might make the difference even on being able to do the project or not.
Mm-hmm.
So I want to mention something close to me, and that is hair. My hair is close to me, right? Yeah. And so the Limmer Hair Transplant Center is who I went to for my hair treatment. And you can do. I'm getting really good results. And they have surgical and non-surgical methods. Dr. Jennifer Krenge and her team is just extremely talented. I wouldn't be talking to you about it if it weren't the type of service that we expect in our company to give to you. And this is just like it. I mean, they're sterling examples of client service. Go to limmerhtc.com. That's Limmer, L-I-M-M-E-R, limmerhtc.com, or call them at 496-9992. That's Limmer Hair Transplant Center. And we'll be right back to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show.
Anthony was working a debt.
It's looking better. Yeah. I mean, really, right?
That's crazy.
And it's not, and it's only that long.
Wow.
So imagine how it's gonna look when it's when
that one.
Well,
right?
I know.
Okay.
Well, that's one. I like the results.
Yeah.
It's funny how no one's talked to me about it yet.
Because of the radio.
Or anything. Or even observations.
Yeah. Well, most people see you every day.
So gradual, right?
Yeah.
I think it's going to happen when you meet people you haven't seen in a while.
Mm-hmm.
Like Michael.
Who's Michael?
On The Office.
Oh.
I always think about him because of what you said.
Yeah.
You said, didn't you notice it?
Yeah.
All on your own?
Yeah. Well, Jared, we've all, everybody did. There's no
really
way.
From one season to the next?
Yeah. We did it in the break.
It was like, what?
Yeah.
It was that obvious, huh?
And I think it was growing. So
oh,
it looked
really?
Pretty funny.
Oh, it did?
Yeah.
So that's why you noticed it, because it looked funny. I heard my commercial on the golf channel.
See it.
Mm-hmm. Especially when you comb it like that.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
And then how about before? That one right down there. Yeah, that one.
That's the first.
Which is after?
First episode.
The one,
this
right?
One, yeah.
Mm-hmm. So what does he look like now without wrinkles? Without his head all wrinkled up?
Like
that. That's not a good, that doesn't post it over his head. How about that one right there?
That's not what he makes his face. What's his name?
He's always making faces.
Oh, this is what he looks like now.
Oh, he looks great. With his gray hair.
Mm-hmm.
And his beard.
He's very handsome.
And he looks way different. He looks so distinguished with the glasses and his
mm-hmm.
beard. He looks like he's almost like a professor.
Mm-hmm. He played like that character that was making in the, what's it called? The Today Show, Matt Lauer. He played they never came out and said, oh, it's about that, but it was about
that.
He played like a Matt Lauer type. It was pretty much the story. Look very
professional. Say you know, you've been able to do like on the product side, I want you to kind of be careful of some things.
Mm-hmm.
Welcome back to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show. I'm Keith, along with Morgan.
Hello, everybody.
If you'd like to talk to us live on the air, you can call us at 737-1200. That's 210-737-1200, because you're listening to AM 1200. 737-1200 is how you get Kurt to get you on the air, and we'll answer your questions live. And we are talking about how to control and reduce costs in remodeling. And before we get into that, I wanted to talk about my friend Hywell Wilson, who's really close to where I live. And because of that, I got to know him for many years now at Certified Small Engine. And that's where you buy all of your lawn care equipment, and you've got the professional tools. So even stuff bigger than, you know, and Home Depot, Lowe's, they sell some of those products too. But I guarantee you he's got products that are bigger and badder than what they carry over there. So if you want something professional or you just want to maintain your equipment, he can do that. Chain everything from a chainsaw on up to a weed eater and so forth. But look him up at certifiedsmallengine.com or call him at 210-523-1138, and he'd be glad to consult with you. Again, go to certifiedsmallengine.com. And it looks like, do we have a call? Yeah, we do. We have a call from James. Go ahead, James. Hey, James, are you there?
Yeah, I'm here. Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
And I'd like to know the cons and pros of storm windows versus replacing my current windows.
Well, that's a great question. We don't do storm windows very much in South Texas. It's very rare to see a home with storm windows on them. I think the big advantage of not going with storm windows is it's going to have better resale and it's going to have better looks, and you don't have to open two windows. But I don't really know the cost difference, James, but I bet you it's probably at least half the cost of new windows, if not more. They're not gonna do the insulating job that a brand new window will. That's what I've seen. They tend to be very, very thin, and you're getting a space between the two windows, but that's not really an insulated space. Eventually that heats up. And so I don't think they do near as good a job as a new window that has a gas in it, an argon gas between it. So if it's anywhere half or more of the cost of new windows, I would highly recommend going with new windows.
Okay, how about, I'm concerned about noise.
Yeah, a good quality window will help you with the noise just as much as a storm window, if not more. Storm windows are not gonna be great, not any better than a dual pane argon filled glass, and there are some other features you can get on windows, new windows, that are even made for around airports and so forth. So there is a special type of window glass, costs a little more, but it can really reduce noise. But I think that most windows that you would put in that are new vinyl type windows are going to reduce the noise so much that you won't even hear the things outside. I have seen this again and again, that people don't know what's going on outside when they get new windows, and that's not storm windows, that's just regular windows.
Okay, well, thank you so much, sir.
Thank you for calling, James. And just like that, you can call us too, and at 737-1200, we'll be glad to answer your questions. That's a good one. We haven't had anybody call about storm windows in a long time. But yeah,
storm windows are mainly for preventing, like, one breaking and then there's another one in a storm, right?
It keeps
the water out, but it's not for...
Yeah, that's what they're originally for, protect another window.
Mm-hmm.
And they do help a little bit on energy, but they're not as much as you think.
Yeah.
Because they're not built very well. Especially if they're inexpensive. And that's usually why people are considering, because they cost less. Nobody buys them for good looks. They're not good looking windows. You've got two windows now to open if you want to. It's just not. And then there's dust.
That's what I have in my bedroom, and it is so dirty.
Yeah.
I mean, hard to keep clean.
Yeah. That's right. You did have a couple of them on yours. That's right.
Yeah, they're weird.
Mm-hmm. And
they're
so,
thick.
Yeah, they make the whole depth of you got to clean two sets of windows technically.
Yeah. And it's hard to clean them.
Mm-hmm. And you got to work around each other and so forth. So I don't recommend them. It's really a thing of the past. It's not very practical, as you said, Morgan. If you just didn't have the money to spend on a window and you had a bad storm or something, it might make sense to put something over it. But again, they're not cheap. To get a good one, they're not cheap either.
Mm-hmm.
So just put it into your new windows, and you'll be happier. Let's talk a little more about what to do to reduce costs and control costs. There's, again, smart design.
Mm-hmm.
And one of the things that a lot of builders do is they just don't get all the information. So if you can't get all the information, you can't give your client any type of guarantee that the price won't change.
Yeah.
And we can give you a price range that it won't change more than maybe $2,000 or $3,000,
mm-hmm.
because we've done our work, and so we're not going to do just a guess at this cost, and then it's on you if we don't get it right.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to do it all the way. And so that's one of the things that can help you control your costs. Get a professional.
Yep.
You should really get a professional and someone who's going to guarantee that the price is going to stay that way.
Mm-hmm. We presented three different design options to a client who has a kitchen that they needed expanded, and it's surrounded by three walls. And basically, we could open up any of the walls, all of the walls, but the educating and knowing which walls were going to be the most cost effective, which ones were most important to the client to open up, that's all part of how to design intelligently and what's going to give you the biggest impact for the lowest amount. And that's knowing with the discovery where exactly the second story hits and lands.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And so that way where we can attach beams to make them more sturdy when we take out the walls, all kinds of different things that, like you said, knowing where the gas is, if we keep the oven in the same location, we're moving it closer, not having to expand the gas line.
Let me ask you this. Do you think just one of our team members could have done all that?
No.
No. What does it take?
Six of us, I think.
Yeah, that's why we use a team when we come to design. We've got people who are experts in everything, and they're looking at it from all different angles.
Yep.
From the architectural design to the interior design to the layout to the structural walls to the components that are in it to would that be possible even? Or would it be expensive? Would it be less if we did this? Oh, somebody came up with a good idea. Why don't we look at it from this? Well, we got the information and we've got the experience. So there can be a lot of savings in doing that discovery process. And I really think it's the biggest thing we do to bring costs down.
I do too.
I have great ideas and great knowledge of the product. And it is hard to measure mm-hmm. how much that is worth.
Yeah.
So, you know, we really think that that's something that makes a big difference. You pay a little bit up front for that service, but it's going to be more than paid for by having great ideas. I want to mention before we go to break, Frank's Paint and Body Shop. He's one of the small guys in the business that does great work. He's done work for Lexus. He does continually work for Lexus of Dominion and probably others too, but that's the one I know of. And he's done multiple jobs for us on our vehicles. And you can contact Frank Menchak at 210-927-3410. No, he doesn't have a website. He's just a guy that you do a handshake with, and he does a great job. 927-3410, Frank's Paint and Body Shop. And we'll be back after the news break to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show.
It's News Radio 1200.
That was so loud.
I didn't know it was that loud when I was had the headphones on. Because it was music.
Yeah. No, it was the guy talking.
No, but before when I had it up that loud, I was trying to hear the music with my headphones on to see so that y'all can see it. Can hear the music. Can't wait to go to the lake tomorrow.
I know, you told me. What time are y'all going?
He's going to enjoy it.
Yeah, he'll love it. Junior swims.
We're supposed to meet their tent at 12. So if we have assembly to go all the way.
Do it early.
We gotta do something right. Yeah. Well, Mom didn't even complain.
She's gonna go to the lots. She don't care.
Oh, you think?
I'm sure.
Maybe.
She's like, I'm gonna go get in the water.
I just wish you'd go with me. It's so much fun.
All those guys.
Well, there's. Well, the last time he brought his wife, and I think I have to take my boat back though now, after this one. I've been liking not having it there.
They probably invited you so that you would pick it back.
No, he said, or do you want to come pick it up? You want to go with us to tune it up, and or do you want to go? You want to come pick it up? So I think this is the last time.
Uh-huh. They're like, bring your truck.
Either way, come.
Huh?
Either way, come.
It would come.
I said, either way, come.
Yeah, come and get it. Yeah.
But I got a nice trailer. Everything works great now. The lights. I just need to get some. I need to get the boat inspected.
Did you hear what I said? Junior swims.
Oh, yeah, we can take him.
Daniel should go get a little life vest for him.
Yeah.
That would be too fun. He would love it. He swims with Tara in the pool.
I wonder if I'll just go get him. Maybe we'll look it up on the way home. You can tell me if the cat has one.
Oh, I would assume PetSmart or something, but yeah, should look it up. Dog.
Flotation. Dog flotation. What'd you look up?
Petco. Life jacket.
Mm-hmm.
Stone milk.
20% off. It's
probably a medium. Not available.
20% off, $50 you buy online and pick up at the store.
The one on Bandera is available in the medium.
Did you see that? 20% off, $50 when you buy online?
Mm-hmm.
How much is it?
$22.49. I don't know if he's a medium or a large.
That's a medium.
I would assume he was a medium. Oh, beagle. Yeah. It says beagle.
Yeah.
Isn't that funny?
So you bought it?
No.
How do you need my card?
Well, I don't know if it'll be available today.
Well, why not?
Or do we want this one?
Which is?
So it's like a, look at that, it looks like Scout.
It does look like a Scout.
Oh my goodness.
Give me the other one. I want to see the other one.
The other one looks more secure, but this one's got a nice
that one,
little...
That one looks on top, so it, instead of underneath.
Yeah. How cute.
How is it rated, that product?
I didn't.
It has a star rating. You missed it. Down a little bit? Down just a
4.5 stars?
Yeah, for that price, 17. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll buy it. Need my card? Or just give you my cash?
You can just give me cash, it'll probably be easier.
$22.49?
Yeah.
I have 22. That would be 49 cents.
You don't have to give me cents.
I don't have it.
I'm like, please do not.
I have it in the car.
I will not.
I didn't think you wanted it anyway.
Okay.
Text that, and can you send in the link?
Mm-hmm.
See, Dad bought this for you, for Junior. The money is here by the end of the day.
Did you tell me?
Welcome to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show. We are talking today about how to control costs and reduce costs in remodeling. That seems to be a subject that interests a lot of folks. Before we take our first caller, Art, we thank you for calling. I just want to mention Quick Roofing. They've been trusted since 1984, and I've used them on even our own family's roofs.
Mm-hmm.
And so, really good job. I can't say enough about the quality that I saw installed. I've been a roofer for many years, too, and it was done right. You can call them at 817-477-0999, but you'll probably just find it easier just to remember to go to quickroofing.com/San Antonio-Texas. Or there's a dash between the San Antonio and the Texas. So anyway, quickroofing.com, and just hit the San Antonio one. And so we will go ahead and take our first caller, Art. We were just talking how
second
we don't get any calls anymore, and you proved us wrong.
Well, yes, sir. And I hope you can steer me in the right direction. I've got a patio cover, a driveway cover, and a patio cover. But in the driveway, there's a big board at the end of the roof line, maybe like a 4x2 or 2x6. And it needs repaired, replaced probably. And then on my back of my house, I've got like a 3x4 or 4x4 piece of wood against that rear patio cover, and it needs to be replaced too. I was just trying to see if you could refer me to somebody that can do some quality work, or if that's something y'all can handle.
Yes. You know, probably could give you a referral on something that small. We do small projects, but usually it's when it's part of a bigger one. Just because of the simple fact that we've got so many people wanting to do larger projects, we can't, we don't do the small ones as much anymore. But yeah, I'll do that. Why don't you do this, since I have my phone recording something right now, recording this show. I can't text you that right now, but you can call the office and we'll give you a referral of someone that does the smaller work. That actually used to be an employee of our company. And that number at the office is 680-5626 or 680-KM-CO.
Monday.
Yeah, that'll be Monday. Sorry. All right. Thank you. Yeah, you too, Art. Thanks for calling the show. All right. So we were talking about controlling costs. And some of the things I thought about have to do with, you know, the design again. If you get real strict with the way you design something, you're going to pay probably a premium. But, you know, I was thinking of like foundations. Foundations can be built in numerous ways, and many of them save a ton of money. The foundation is a very expensive part of a project. If you're doing an addition, even a new home, I mean, you can do foundations in many different ways, and a lot of people really, really like them. A lot north, you know, because of freeze levels and how cold the ground is and so forth, there's different methods used, and some of those are actually cost-saving. And you can use some of those methods down here. Even pier and beam homes, down here, if you build an addition, a pier and beam, well, pier and beam foundation is a really good way to go, especially if it's high off the ground. And you can make it look just like the rest of the home. Of course, if your home is already pier and beam, you should probably stick with that. But there's other things you can do, such as pour a perimeter beam and then pour joist, put joist over that. So you really have a lot of different ways you can do a foundation. And those are just two of several different ways that you can build a foundation. When it comes to products, I know Morgan is very much involved in products. You can think of a few products that can help people to save significant money on their project.
Mm-hmm. You know, even when going with the cabinets, what line and how much flexibility you need when you're designing your kitchen. Because going up cabinet lines, we're dealers for cabinets, but when you start getting into higher levels, the cost increases in your kitchen 20 to 60, 80%. And the reason that people have to go up is because they want certain, they may want certain special features mm-hmm. or certain, like to fit this width of a cabinet, then they don't make it in that line. Well, if you're okay with putting a little filler piece there, you can save $20,000.
Because you can have to switch lines.
Yes, and you can't go with one line for one piece and then use another line because right. they don't make the same finishes purposefully.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and so that's
one
advantage.
Huge savings.
And that is one advantage that a design team like ours can bring to the table.
Mm-hmm.
They can show you this is how it can be done or this is how it can be done because we have multiple lines of cabinetry that we offer.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what do you think is going to happen when you go to a builder that has either zero lines of cabinets or one line of cabinetry? He can't give you that flexibility and he can't give you that break in the price.
Exactly.
And of course, everybody knows there's custom built too as well. But
that's what everyone has access to, though.
And they think that that's cheaper, and it's
yes.
not. The reason we're actually selling manufactured cabinets is because the quality is so high, but the price is less than the custom. And custom is not the same quality.
Mm-mm.
In most cases, there's a few exceptions, but the ones that are the exceptions are not less expensive. They're way more.
Yes.
And you pay for that, and there's a lot of other issues that can happen as well.
Mm-hmm.
So we used to do that all custom from the best custom cabinet maker in San Antonio, and I have a lot of respect for him. He does a heck of a job.
Yeah.
But we're trying to bring costs down for our clients, not just give them, okay, well, here it is.
Wood is so expensive. That's what your cabinets are made out of.
Yeah. And so that has gone up lately, but again, we have to be creative and solution finders for you.
Mm-hmm.
And this is how we do it. Other products, too, that come to mind are like LVP.
Mm-hmm.
You may have said, well, I have to have this. Well, until you've seen it and walked on it and tried it and looked at all the advantages and disadvantages, and some products there really is no disadvantage, it's just people's mindset. I had a friend who came over to my house and said, I thought you were going to put LVP. I said, it is. He said, what? I said, I told you it looks real. You can't tell the difference. I can't tell. And he was kind of disappointed because he had gone with real wood and he paid more. And, you know, they've already got scratches in it.
Yep. If you have dogs, you will scratch your wood.
Yeah, and if you have kids, grandkids, you're going to do it. If you have sand anywhere in your yard, or
if you wear heels,
yeah. So again, looking and getting advice can make a big difference in your. And we're talking thousands of
yeah.
dollars in difference.
Mm-hmm.
So before we go to the break, I want to talk about BioGreen, my secret weapon on my yard, Joe Pacino, and yours too. She's got him too now. That's right, and so do my neighbors.
Yeah,
one of my neighbors I know has it. Amanda's his yard look good, do we?
Oh, I know, I saw it.
Man.
They look great.
Yeah. And so biogreensa.com is how you find out more. 210-421-9522, 421-9522.
And they also do sprinkler systems.
That's right, irrigation systems, which you got one too,
mm-hmm.
didn't you?
Yes.
Yeah, biogreensa.com, and we'll be back.
Dad, I just love my new KMS. master suite remodel, and it went so smooth.
Morgan, your concepts and our design team really shine. But what do you think our clients would appreciate the most?
Definitely the daily communication. Every morning there was a text message telling me exactly what to expect that day. Everyone was so talented and extremely kind.
I am proud that our team treats all of our clients like that. Call 680-KM-CO. Let us design your experience.
Or go to kmbuilders.com.
Those who build their own financial success
really get just as good results.
Requires not just the right tools.
It's really cool. Like when that commercial played, I was thinking about my bathroom and how my bathroom has influenced so many clients to go with a shower ledge. Being able to like show that in real life, like I had seen it once on Pinterest. And I knew that it was just like the practical solution that I feel a lot of females are looking for, because we buy the jumbo Costco size shampoos and conditioners with the pumps, and no one likes the niches because they don't fit. I mean, you'd have to have a super tall niche. And so when
I do that on my shower,
absolutely. Yeah. But it's just so like that's really important to be able to. Like, I just really hope that you'll be able to do your house soon to show features, because it does sell if we can show the concepts in real life and have people that we know use it. Yeah, because trying to explain that feature to them, they're just like, what? A ledge? Like, and it floats? And no, it's tiled. Oh, pull it up. Oh, Morgan, that's your bathroom? Oh, yeah, I want that. And that's just, it happens. We just are selling so many of that concept because when it makes sense, it really makes sense. And we don't want to put a niche in the outside wall. But that's where they really need one, because that's where it makes sense to put it.
You know, stuff, it's like too much.
Yeah.
I still like one. I'd like one, you know, whatever size it takes on it. On the two sides of the shower entrance, where you don't see it from the
ledge or a niche.
One on each side.
Mm-hmm. I mean, a lot of people like them, but then where's your plumbing go? You know, because you have
takes
the
more
lines.
Time. You have to go around it.
Yeah.
It's okay.
it's just more expensive.
Just control the house.
No, it's not. Was the shower line where the shower comes out?
No, but the control on the other side.
On the
wall that you walk into.
That's where the
control valve would be, and then it's just a supply line coming to it.
Yeah.
And it can come down real low below the niche, and then go back up to the shower head.
Around. Most people don't put niches right below the shower.
No. So here's your shower. You walk in here,
mm-hmm.
and you have your ledge here.
Mm-hmm.
I put the niches here. You walk in the middle, and you put the niches on this wall.
Oh, because that's how you're going to have your shower?
No, where you walk in the middle.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Big enough to where you can walk
and
in the middle.
It's tiled on each side? You know,
glass
on the sides?
And half wall.
Oh, okay.
Half walls and glass.
Yeah, because then I was
and
like, how
have,
are you putting niches?
And you have a shower control valve for each one over here. And then next to the valve is a
and
niche.
And where's your shower heads?
Here and here.
Oh, okay.
And so this is just a wall that has nothing like flawless.
Yeah.
Except maybe a bench here and a bench here. That's what
weird
I
design.
No, it's not. It's a beautiful design. For two people. That's a two-figure design.
Most people wouldn't want that on the middle, because if you're gonna spend all that money, you want to put a rain head in the middle.
Still do rain head, but
not
it's not open. It's a door.
It's weird.
I'm gonna do rain head on this side. Welcome back to the KM Builders Remodeling and Design Show. I'm Keith, along with Morgan.
Hello, everybody.
And we're glad you joined us. And we have one little segment left. I want to mention Mickey Snyder
nonetheless, said Marty, got a new project manager named Marty. Hi, Marty. Yeah. But Mickey Schneider and Gavin, his son, Gavin gave me a call yesterday. So we're going to the lake with the wonderful boat that they rebuilt for me at Medina Lake. There's still a little bit left in there. We can go in it. And Medina Lake's still beautiful when you get in the right spot. So we're going to do it probably the last hurrah on Medina Lake, unless it rains. But if you'd like to have your truck, your car, or your boat worked on, I highly, highly recommend Mickey and his team at Rio Medina Truck and Auto Repair and Marine. And you can look them up at RioMedinaTruckAutoRepair.com. RioMedinaTruckAutoRepair.com. Or call them at 830-931-9060. I mean, took care of the upholstery, the paint, the trailer, the lights, the engine, everything. Rebuilt part of the boat that was rotten. I didn't know it, but he said, you need to replace this. So we did it. And very fair pricing, too. So great team over there. If you have an old restore car or boat or truck, they can do that, too. Let's just finish up on our subject of how to control and reduce prices. Again, designing intelligently, using materials that can give you a similar look. For example, I mean, we're doing one right now where the floor looks just like marble, but it's not. And it's actually easier to maintain. Costs a lot less, too. Mm-hmm. And so there's products out there that you may not be aware of that we can help you. You need to know what we know to be able to help you. As Morgan mentioned earlier, we're dealers for products, so that cost us about 20% less. And so if we keep our cost down, we add our profit margin and our overhead to it, it's going to end up costing you less. Mm-hmm. We have a 50-person staff. That helps reduce costs because we don't have as many subcontractors as other contractors use. A lot of in-house trades on your project will be used, and that's going to control not only cost, but quality and scheduling much, much better. It's tough in these days to control scheduling with all the things working against us. We've got a lot of people out with COVID right now, but you've got to have people at least to be able to tackle it. If you don't have any people of your own, you're really up a creek. And fortunately, we do. We have a lot of folks, and we're always trying to hire another person for this or that and to keep it going. But it's hard. In this market, it's hard to hire, and it's hard to keep people healthy. But we're doing it, and in spite of the heat and in spite of COVID, we're keeping things rolling. So pay attention to your contractor's processes. Does he have in-house design? Is it complete, or is it just subcontracted out, or you have to go and get your own? That's not going to end up in a good design, and it's not going to lead to flexibility in the design that you need to be able to keep your costs down. Again, we also have a buying co-op, not just a dealership, but we're part of a buying co-op. Then our lumber prices to you are about 38% less than if we were not part of this co-op. Mm-hmm. Do you get guarantees on prices not exceeding? If you want to do some things on your own, you can do a little demo, maybe some painting. That would help bring some of the cost down. It's not usually as much as people think, but that would help the cost. The main thing is keep it simple. If you really want to keep it down, then don't move stuff around. Don't change the location of too many things. And that would also help a lot. But remember this, that you spend a little more, you will get more. When it comes to resale, people will pay you full dollar and more for what you spent if it was professionally designed. If it's just a simple makeover, then be prepared for not even to get paid. Even though you're spending less, you will probably not get full payback whenever you go to sell. You'll still get to enjoy it, but you won't get full payback. You spend about 30% more, you're going to get more than the payback. And so you need to think about that when you're investing in it. You can save less, you can save some, but be careful not to be penny wise and dollar foolish when it comes to your designs. At KM Builders, we never have a sale and we never have discounts because every time we are going into an exact quote for what everything you want. And that price is only going to be determined after a full design process. You can contact us. We're at kmbuilders.com or 680-KM-GO. We'd love to have you call, and I'll come out and visit you. 680-KM-GO, because at KM Builders, we have designed the experience.
So you can experience the design.
Have a great weekend, everybody.
The preceding show.